So, us talking about the music and everything else and what's going on and the flashing and flossing. And that's what's been flossing in a lot of these music videos is these exotic guns and weapons with banana clips and I'll shoot you up 100 shots. You know, that's, you know what they talk about.
Yeah, 30-odd clips and everything like that. I mean, damn, man.
Could it be a strategic plan to destroy a culture?
I mean, you got alcohol, you got drugs. What's the next thing?
But guns kills you quicker.
Right, so the ones, well, you know, we had crack out there. And this one doing it fast enough, so let's do this right here. The crackhead kids, their mind is already gone. They already violent. It's coming out the womb.
Now let's give them a gun.
Let's give them a gun.
And let's give them dumb shit to watch on TV. To make them even act more stupid, to think that's the way you survive and the way you do things in life in this world, I guess. Is that what we saying?
Look, they walking around saying I got a Draco, man. I didn't even know what the hell it was at first, man.
I never knew what the fuck a Draco was, neither.
Until somebody had to break
it
down.
You got handguns that's 50 to 100 clips. What the fuck? And can't no semi do that. Only a fully. And so you got a fully automatic. This what this guy was saying in the 90s and the 99s. These were the type of guns that were being dropped off. So some of these guns been around for a long time floating through Chicago. I don't know, man. Some things are just fishy.
Just obvious. Very obvious.
You know? So.
And then, like, you get, okay, like, what I carry. I'm going to have 6-shot 38. Now, yeah, if I shoot and I don't shoot accurately, I can shoot somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
But that's maybe just one other person. When you spraying like that with
and
30
you can't
clip,
shoot accurately and not properly trained, shit, that's 30 to 40-some bullets at a time.
And that's not even built for that. I mean, those type of, that type of artillery, that's not built for you shooting accurately, man. That's what's spraying.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, so we got a bigger issue that we need to look at in Chicago first. We need to look at the root cause. Where the fuck is this shit coming from? Once you figure out where the fuck the shit coming from, then you can start weaseling out the ones that's making things happen. You get what I'm saying?
No, most definitely.
So, you know, small little thing we want to touch on, man. Gonna get to some more music. Come back. Gonna wrap up the show. This is the Live and Direct Show. Me and the homie Smokey D down here in the Player K right here on Black Hippie Radio Entertainment. Don't forget y'all can catch that album, that 444 album right here on the radio station and the motherfucking website. For y'all listening pleasures. Gonna be back in y'all here. This is Game Dreams.
I woke up out that coma 2001. About the same time Dre dropped 2001. 3 years later, the album is done. Aftermath presents Nigga With An Attitude, Volume 1. Rap critics politicking, wanna know the outcome. Ready to die reasonable, doubting doggy style in one. I feel like Pac after the Snoop Dogg trial was done. Dre behind that G-Series and All Eyes On Me. I watched the death of a dynasty, so I told Vibe magazine. Working with Dr. Dre was a... I had visions of making a classic. Then my world turned black, like I was staring out of Stevie Wonder's glasses. It's kinda hard to imagine, like Kanye West coming back from a fatal accident to beat making and rapping. But we the future. Whitney Houston told me that, and it's gonna take more than a bullet in the heart to hold me back.
Rushing in this 40 ounce, letting the ink from my pen bleed. Cause Martin Luther King had her, Aaliyah had her, left eye had her. So I reached out to Kanye
and I brought you all my dreams. Cause I love you.
I had dreams of fucking a R&B bitch like Maya. When I saw that ass on the front of that King, read the article in the magazine. She loved gangsters, loved nasty things. So I'm in the glass house having nasty dreams. Good girls never give it up, but anything is possible. If 50 fuck Vivica, hurdle life's obstacles, found my way through the maze. Then joy turned to pain like Frankie Beverly and Maze. Used to dream of being unsigned hype till I was crushed by Dave Mays. Almost let my pen fall asleep on the page. Daydreaming yesterday, dozing off backstage. I thought I saw Easy talking to Jam Master J. So I walked over, heard Jam Master say, it's a hard knock life, then you pass away. They say sleep is the cousin of death. So my eyes wide open, cause a dream is kin to your last breath. Rushing in this 40 ounce, letting the ink from my pen bleed. Cause Martin Luther King had her, Aaliyah had her, Left Eye had her. So I reached out to Kanye and I brought you all my dreams, cause I love dream of Huey Newton, that's what I'm living through. The dream of Eric Wright, that's what I'm giving you. Who walked through the White House without a business suit? Compton had Jerry Curl dripping on Ronald Reagan shoes. Gave Michael in my demo, came here to pay my dues. Started off with Who Kid, then I start blazing Clue. It was all a dream like Big said it be. Don't sleep on me, homie, I bring nightmares to reality. Rap phenomenon, defying the rules of gravity. Studied all the classics, start revising my strategy. Cause Marshall Mathers made it, Curtis Jackson made it. Head in the clouds, wondering where the hell Marvin Gaye went. How do I say this? I'm living for my son, but I can't figure out why I'm at my temple with this gun. Wake up to a Jesus piece like a Catholic nun. The war to be a rap legend has just begun. Rushing in this 40 ounce, letting the ink from my pen bleed. Cause Martin Luther King had Aaliyah had her, Left Eye had her, so I reached out to Kanye and I brought you all my dreams, cause I love you. This song is dedicated to your Tunde Price, the sister of Venus and Serena Williams.
Back with you ready on entertainment down here in the Player Cave, me and the homie Smokey D. Down here just chilling. Gonna wrap up the show. Hope y'all enjoy it. Catch this podcast on the website. You can also catch it right here on Spreaker.com. Make sure I give my shout out to them. You got some shout outs you want to do, man?
Shout outs to all the listeners out there. Make sure you tell your friends, spread the word. Make sure it gets out there, man.
You've been spreading the word, man.
Of course,
man. You've been telling people to listen, man.
You got a cat from North Carolina going all the way to Utah yesterday. Let him know. You know, he was talking insightful, so let him know. I said, check this out. Why don't you go ahead and listen to this show?
That's dope.
So hopefully he gets on there. You know, a couple of Lyft drivers, Uber drivers, and all of that.
That's dope, man. We got to get some, like, some some flyers or something, put some shit like that together. And that's how you spread the word even more. I'm going to start leaving flyers on people's cars and all that other stuff.
I'm going to start DMing these porn stars I got on Instagram. Fuck it.
Hey, yeah, shit. I promote the porn stars, you know.
No, they going to listen to us. Man, I don't give a damn. Man, they already promoted. We want promotion.
Right.
Man, once you get $10 for your autograph, you know what I'm saying?
Maybe get some shirts and have them throw on a few shirts or whatever. Go over here to do it that way. You know?
A real talk, man. I knew a motherfucker who actually, I forgot what it's called. Oh, Lucky Living.
Mm-hmm.
Then I look up, Cherokee Diaz had his shirt on, man. I'm like,
there you go. There you go. I actually had, what was the stripper name? I had got in contact with her. I'm going to think of her name. I can't think of her name. But this was some years ago. And I was telling her, you know, I was starting out with this brand and everything else. And she actually hit me back. Like, okay, what is it? But me, you know, it was fresh starting off. I'm like, okay. I don't know what to say back to this chick right about now.
No, you want Black Hippie? I mean, no.
Yeah, I froze up, man. I ain't going to lie to you. I froze up.
No, not you, Hippie.
Yeah, I froze up, man. Like I said, I was just starting off Black Hippie Radio Entertainment, man. So, you know, it was just, you know, I ain't think she was going to answer back. I was just like, hey, I was high, like, hey, fuck it, let me go ahead and do it. And she answered back, and I froze up and didn't respond back. So I apologize. I know what stripping is, but no, I remember what porn star it is. But I'll get back to you, man. You know, let you know who that was. Because you probably didn't watch that before.
Oh, yeah, I have.
So, you know, catching all another. Like, when you coming back, man? You want to do this again?
Let's see here.
Tomorrow, the 4th of July, so you know.
So they got me at 3:11 there, and I'm off Wednesday and Thursday.
So we can come right back Wednesday and Thursday.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll be back in y'all here doing it again right here on Black Hippie Radio Entertainment, chilling down here in the player cage like we normally do. Like I said, y'all can catch the 444 album right here on the website and on the video station. Don't forget the page, the Black Hippie Radio Entertainment fan page on Facebook. Also, to bring your A-Game Sports Talk group. Yeah, check that out on Facebook too, man. We're gonna get back to that too, man. We're gonna do a sports show, man. Nah, Thursday.
Well, for sure. I mean, we got it all, but the OTA is already. Mm-hmm. Oh, so, they started already.
I don't know. We're gonna look into all that. You know, we're gonna get this sports show prepared, because when we come back, we gotta make it a little bit more better.
I got you, yeah.
So we're going to get more back into Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. Y'all can also catch that right here on the Black Hippie Radio Entertainment website. Oh, no, Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk got his own website. You see, we've gone away from him too long, I forgot it had his own website.
Well, man, you brought it back, though.
But there it is, man. Y'all enjoy yourself, Chicago, man. Stop killing each other. Be back in y'all.